playing Ambo. I was playing handball and well, you're talking about 40 years ago, I don't remember well, but I was playing handball and she has stole some. Some of her friends. I came out in a talent show in the school. School before they had talent show. I don't know if they still have it. So they had a talent show, and I always like to dance. And in this. There was a talent show in high school, and I tried out for dancing, and I went in as a dancer, dancing. And she told a friend that she likes me. I didn't know her then, but the friend told me that she liked. So we were. I was downstairs and down playing handball, and she came over, and she asked me. She actually came to me and told me, "You don't want to dance," and blah 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 blah. I said, yeah. And by the way, I don't know, man. That's how it started. I took me dancing and we established a friendship. And all of a sudden, she's my girlfriend. And that's how it started. I don't know.
Well, I met Angel in high school. I was 15 years old. I was just going into high school, Franklin K. Lane High School in Queens. We were introduced by some other students that were in my class, and he's always been in the music. He's always had that in him, the music, and there was a talent show at the school, and he was going to be in it. Oh, no. There was a talent show. I went to the talent show, and he was performing. And so happens that he was in the class of one of my classmates. And I asked her, did you see that cute guy that was dancing on the stage? And she says, yeah, he's in my class. He says, oh, yeah? Oh, that's nice. She says, well, do you want to meet him? And I said, yeah, I do. I was only 15, just getting into high school. And she introduced us, and then the next day, I was coming into school to the courtyard. You have to walk down a long road to get to the front of the school. And he was there like this, you know, hanging on the fence like that. And the girl introduced us, and he walked me all the way down into the entrance of the school, and he asked my name. And I don't remember everything, you know, this is 50 years ago. And that's it, the rest is history. We went out on November the 14th, 1965. That was our first date. We went to the Fox Theater in Brooklyn, New York, on, I think it was on 4th Avenue and Atlantic Avenue. But there was a good downside. I could go to the movies with him, but I had to take one of my brothers or sisters as a chaperone. And I did. And I took my, the first one that went, the first victim was my sister Josie. And she went with us to the movie. She sat right in front of us. And we were watching some military movie. I don't even know. I don't remember the name. I do believe it was Sidney Poitier. He was the actor, the main actor. And then the next week we went out again, or whenever it was. And I had to take my other little brother, which was probably my brother Edwin. May he rest in peace. And every week, or whenever we went out, we had to take someone. Until my mother, I guess she, you know, she, I got her good side, and we were able to go out alone. Well, he was kind. He was a kind person, very loving person, very kind, very sassy, you know, cute. You know, he always dressed very nice. He went to school with a jacket, and in those days they used cufflinks. So he had real heavy cufflinks on. You know, the shirts that have a big cuff, and he had cufflinks that had rhinestones on it. And he used to go to school like that.
That was another thing that I didn't know that was going to happen while I was married. I didn't go into the music. It happens to happen. And I became a singer, I became very famous. I made a lot of money. And I could say he's a lucky man to have her. If I would have another woman, I don't know. I think it is meant to be. I believe in destiny. That's my destiny. A changed thing, but she, like I said, she was always there with the kids, and she supported me. She supported me. Happened and I took care of business. You know.
My favorite was always we used to go away a lot. We love road trips. We used to go to the beach a lot. But road trips were the best. When we went to Disney when I was pregnant from Carlin. And Canice was like 4 years, yeah, she was about 4 years old. And it was like a spontaneous trip with Francis. And then we invited my niece, Elaine, and my sister, Bernice. And it was so spontaneous that we couldn't find a hotel in the middle of July. And we had a Cadillac. And we drove down. I was 7 months pregnant. And it was we'll never forget that experience. It was so crowded, you know, coming down to Florida. We couldn't find a hotel, so Angel slept on top of the car. That was something very memorable. And my niece Elaine and my sister Bernice, they will never forget that. They will never forget how pain in the butt Canice was. And Francis, they loved it. We went down to Daytona Beach. Yeah, and many other, so many other trips, so many other good memories. We had our good parties for New Year's and Christmas where we had the whole family over. We've only been in this house for 3 years, but the house that we had before, we had some good memories there, a lot of parties.
Oh, I really wanted to know anything. We did it all. We were small. Oh, when we had Francis. I said, boy, I'm a father. And that was a song called Mi Niña Bonita. I sang for her when she was born. And I recorded it. It was a smash hit. It was a hit. But yeah, that was a moment when I was just 18 or something. No, I was more than that. And I said, I'm a father. Oh. And we enjoy it. We took out everywhere with us. We didn't have a kid until 7 years later. Another one. But we had a great time. It's like, I remember today. Yeah. We went out, we used to go everywhere. You know. It was nice. One on one. Nice baby. My niece was born. When Canis was born, I was very hot in New York and all these places where I played. Oh, my first son. When I found out when it was a boy, I said, oh, my name is Ratu. Canis came 3 years, 4 years later, after Canis. He never saw me singing live. He seen the videos. But he never saw me. He was born in 82. And at that time, there was no video. We didn't thank him. And it was great. It was great. I don't complain about life.
Did Francis and Canis get to see him perform live in concert?
Francis did. At the Madison Square Garden gig. Yeah, she was. That's my daddy. Yeah. Yeah. It was an exciting time. It was a nice era.
Patience. 50 years of patience, a lot of patience. Yeah, I think patience is very important, and I think that's really the main thing that keeps them together. Patience. Yeah. Let's see. There's so many. She was like my grandmother, Mommy Audia. So she's like, just. And I can't say this without crying. Tolerance, just loving and just being there, you know, just great example. Stop, Rihanna. Just being the great example. Well, you already spoke about patience. That's, yeah, just to be humble, you know, and my mom too. To try and be humble. This is hard, you know, right?
What I learned from my parents, from observing from their marriage, is you never give up. My mom and dad have gone through the saying, for better, for worse, till death do you part, and richer and poor. is 1,000% true, and I learned that, and I took that away in my own marriage. You just don't give up. I never seen my parents argue. Her work ethic, both of them, but definitely mommy, because mommy worked in the corporate world, and I think I followed suit in that with her. She definitely has excellent work ethics. As a mother, something that I remember was you always served your husband and your children before you served yourself. Probably you don't see that often anymore. And your kids come first, and your spouse. Totally. I learned a lot of things. But you know, something that always sticks in my mind with my dad was, take care of your car and your car will take care of you. Something that I always think about. La vida es una caja de sorpresa. Life is like, I guess, what is la vida de la caja? La vida es una caja de sorpresa. Yes. Life is a box of surprises, and he was totally on point.
You know, it's funny. This is what? This is just for like us, for the family? So mom, pop always used to, and I actually kind of mentioned this in the speech. I would actually catch Poppy fondling mommy in the kitchen. Brianna, close your ears. I would catch, grab mom, but in a loving way, you know. It was very much nothing nasty, nothing crazy. It was just in a very loving, affectionate way. The hugging, kissing in the sala or the kid, whatever it was. And it always had a big impact on me because I always saw that love. I always saw the affection that they had for each other. The true affection, the genuine affection. And I do the same with Bea now. And that's kind of, I always tell her that's where I got it. I always saw that growing up. I saw that love with my parents. I saw that affection between them. And it's something that always impacted me. It's something that I always wanted. I always looked forward to when I had a wife. So now I do the same with her. So that's probably one of the biggest impacts they definitely had on me. Oh my God, jeez. To narrow it down, being there, just hanging out. My dad always took me around everywhere. I mean, I used to go with him to work during summer vacations. He would literally take me to work every day. We'd go to the beach every weekend and just ride bike. He'd take me to the arcade in Hollywood Beach. And we would just hang and just talk and chill and relax. And it was more that relationship, basically building that relationship with me is what I'm trying to do with my kids, is hang out with them, be there for them, you know. He took me to it was Grand Prix back in the day. I forget what it is now. Boomers. Taking me to Boomers, taking me to the batting cage, taking me to the arcade, just hanging out with me. So always being there for me, always wanting to do stuff with me, kind of always being his sidekick. And it just showed me how to have that relationship with my kids, just to be there, just to hang out, just to do stuff with them. It showed me the importance of just being there for them, you know. And I know a lot of people with a lot of fathers that they may have been there physically, but they weren't there. They weren't hanging out with them. They weren't doing things with them. Thankfully, Pop always did stuff with me. He always brought me along. He wanted me to be around. So I try to do the same to my kids. I want them to be around me. I want them to hang out with me. I want to go with them. I like doing things with them on the weekend. You know, I spent 4 hours today with them at the pool just hanging out. I want that to be as impactful for them as it was for me. One, how to be a handyman. Mom, it's funny, mom was always more the handy woman than anything, doing things around the house. So I definitely picked that up. I definitely picked up how to, just watching her do things around the house, fix things, always having things organized, all that stuff. I definitely picked that up from her. Yeah.
Well, since I was the one that was exposed to it the most, I didn't see him as much as Canales and Carlin did, you know, so he was always out at night. So that's why we went, that's why everything that he did as a family together, it was very important that we go on those amusement parks and, you know, those little midnight runs and stuff like that. I don't know, normal. I didn't feel anything different. I didn't get any special treatment or anything like that, which is fine, you know. But nothing out of the ordinary. So.
You know, I never really understood that until probably when I was in maybe middle school, maybe fifth grade is when I realized, okay, you know what, my dad, there's something famous about him. And when I realized that my dad was really famous and I knew people that knew him was when I was in my 20s. Yeah. And I was like, wow, my dad really is famous. You know, we would, a good one is I took him to this radio store in Hialeah called Impel America. And people just started coming up to my dad, all these Colombians and Venezuelans, and asking him, are you on him Canales? And I was like, really? Whole shit. People really do know my dad. What was it like being the daughter? It really wasn't, nothing changed in the house because he never really, that I remember, brought it too much home. So it wasn't like, you know, we had paparazzi or anything. But I definitely realized it when I was in my 20s and saw that a lot of people that I knew, that I associated with, listened to my dad's music. And probably when he, in high school, he started traveling again when we moved down here in 92, 93. And we would see the videos and I would be like, oh my God, all those people went to go see my dad? Like, wow. So, yeah, it wasn't really until my 20s that I really started to understand, wow, you know, he really was famous back in the day. So, and still is.
You know, it's funny. I never felt that. And maybe it's, I don't know if people, you know, sons of or kids of super famous, like big time celebrities feel this, but it was always just Poppy. It wasn't, I remember as a kid, every once in a while, a fan would see him, oh my God, Angel Canales, and want to talk to him. And I didn't see it all the time, so he was always just Pop. I didn't really start to recognize how big he was until I got older. I was already, you know, in my 20s, and I actually started meeting people that would see my last name, like, hey, Canales. You ever heard of Angel Canales? Yeah, it's my dad. Oh my God, and it just sparked into this whole conversation of how much they love his music and the impact they had on him. And it was way later on that I started to realize that and started to come in contact with that. But growing up, it was never, I knew who he was, I knew about the music, I knew that stuff, but it was he was just Poppy to me. It was just the guy I would, like I said, like I would just hang out with and chill with. It was never this big celebrity status person. He's just my dad.
A lot. I guess maybe he was always fun. Always took us to the park and bike riding whenever he had a chance. You know, he was always working and my mom too, but he, you know, the trips to the park or to the, there was a place in Howard Beach that we used to go to in New York with a little amusement park that was really, every Easter, used to go there a lot, yeah. Carvel ice cream runs and Papaya House hot dogs and Orange Julius's in the middle of the night. We'd just get up and go. Yeah, that was fun. Gosh, there's so many. To pinpoint, childhood memories with them, I don't know. There's just the midnight runs are the ones that just stick to me that were so important, you know. The ice cream, he loves ice cream. That's basically everything, and I'm sure it's probably the same thing that Carlin and Camille told you, you know?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Madison Square Garden. Yeah, that was exciting. I saw him on stage. We were about like in the fifth row. I fell asleep towards the end because it was just so much noise. I was about 10 years old. And that was exciting to see him on stage and just perform. And that was a great era. I was happy to be a part of it. Yeah, really.
I had a very great childhood growing up with my parents, especially my dad. My dad was very spontaneous, and we did a lot of spontaneous trips to Florida, to say the least. A lot of memorable trips to Daytona Beach. Lots and lots of bike rides in Flushing Meadow Park, down all the way to Shea Stadium and back. Running around in Cunningham Park in Jamaica Estates was a great memorable, was pretty memorable with my dad. Lots of bike rides, my dad, me and Carlin, here in Hollywood Beach. We did that for many years until we got older and we started working. We did a lot of that when we moved here. So he definitely was a big part in our lives. He still is, but he was definitely around a lot. Taught us a lot of things growing up. I could go on and on. And my mom, you know, I'll give you a great memory. My mom worked in the city, and every Friday, Papi would pick us up and take the scenic route to the city. We would go through Brooklyn, go through the bridges, and we would stop and eat pizza, or he would take us to Papaya King to have hot dogs, and we would wait for my mom to come out on Fridays, and that was another great experience that we did a lot with Papi and Mommy.
It's a good question. It's a really good question. Favorite memory. Probably when I used to play Little League. Definitely when I used to play Little League. I remember Mom would come out to the games, and Dad, Papi, sometimes he'd show up late, sometimes he'd be there on time, but he would always be the guy coming from the car. He had his little beach chair, and he would sit behind the home plate, kind of just back there observing, watching me, screaming at me, watch the ball. Mom would be in the stand, and it was probably every game. I mean, they definitely made it to the majority of the games, and that always meant a lot to me. Just to see him out there, just to know he was back there screaming at me, to hear his voice, watch the ball, you know, pay attention, was always real comforting. Just to know Mom's out there watching me, that was always a big thing for me.
I just appreciate the good times that we had. That's the most memorable, and appreciate the respect that we have for each other. We have a lot of respect for each other, a lot of discipline, and a lot of patience. That's the most important part, a lot of patience. So this is where we're at now. Now we're enjoying our grandkids. My beautiful granddaughter, Celeste, graduated from college. Then Brianna, our second granddaughter. Then Caleb, our third grandson. our third grandchild. Then Avery, and then Ryan, and now Noah. And they're a blessing. We love them so, so much. And we enjoy being around them. I love being a grandma. And I love being a mother, of course. And a wife, and, you know, all that that comes with it.
Yeah, you could say I'm a happy man. I have everything I want. I don't need anything. Health. I've been a lucky man, that's all.